Hello friends, in this video we discuss about basic concept of oscillation and free oscillation. So objective of this video is to understand and study the basic concept related to oscillation and their first type of oscillation, that is free oscillation. So initially we talk about the definition of oscillation. So it is movement back and forth in a regular rhythm, or it is a periodic motion, that is motion that repeats over time. Now here we can see the schematic of oscillation. So first two figures shows there is a back and forth motion, and the second figure shows that there is a up and down motion is there. Okay, so animation of this second figure shown here. Okay, here we can see the spring oscillates up and down. Okay, so this is about the oscillation. After that we discuss fundamental terms. So first, a rectilinear motion. So it is a motion of an object along a straight line called rectilinear motion. Now here we can see the examples of the rectilinear motion. Now when we can say that the object is in rectilinear motion? If that object changes their position and they move along a straight line path, then we can say that that object is in rectilinear motion. Understood? Now here in both the examples, object change their position and moves along a straight line path. Here we can see, so, and that is nothing but the rectilinear motion. Okay, now second, projectile motion. This projectile motion produced by an object or a particle that is projected near the earth surface and moves along a curved path under the action of gravity. Now here we can see the example of projectile motion. Now here cannon ball shot from a cannon and which moves along a curved path under the action of gravity, and this object projected near the earth surface, and that is nothing but the projectile motion. Okay, now circular motion. Now motion of an or motion of a body along a circular path called as a circular motion. Now here we can see the example of circular motion, that is Ferris wheel. Now this wheel moves along a circular path, okay, and hence it is known as a circular motion. Now after that, rotational motion. It is a circular movement of an object around the axis or center of rotation called as a rotational motion. Now what is mean by axis of rotation or center of rotation? Now here we can see this figure, then it is observed that it is the point, from that point the object rotate, that is nothing but the axis of rotation. Now here we can see there are some example of rotational motion like spinning top, Ferris wheel, rotating blades of helicopter, earth rotating on its own axis. So these are some example of the rotational motion. Okay, now periodic motion. A motion which repeats itself after a regular interval of time called as a periodic motion. Now the best example of periodic motion is the pendulum clock. Now this pendulum clock repeats itself after a fixed time interval, and hence this is an best example of periodic motion. Okay, now oscillatory motion. It is back and forth motion of an object about its mean position called as a oscillatory motion. Now here we can see the example of the oscillatory motion. Now this is the oscillatory motion, that is there is a back and forth motion like this. Okay, now another example, that is swing. Now this swing also rotate or moves about its mean position like this, and that motion is a back and forth motion. So these are the example of the oscillatory motion. Understood? Now another basic term related to oscillation, that is frequency. Now frequency is nothing but number of cycle or oscillations completed per second. Or another definition of frequency, it is the reciprocal of the time period. Its unit is per second, or another unit we can say hertz. Okay, now next definition is time period. Time period is nothing but the time required to complete one oscillation or a cycle of motion, that is nothing but the time period. And time period can be measured in a second. Now next definition, wavelength. Here we can see the wavelength. Distance from the top of one crest to the top of other crest, or it is the distance from the one trough to the other trough, called as a wavelength. Here we can see this is the crest and this is the trough. Now distance between these two successive crest, or distance between these two successive trough, that is nothing but the wavelength. And this wavelength can be measured either in meter, centimeter or angstrom. Okay, now next definition, amplitude. Here we can see the amplitude is there, and it is the maximum displacement from the equilibrium position. Now this is the equilibrium position, or we can say that the mean position. So the distance from the mean position, and that distance is a maximum, or maximum distance from its a mean position, called as a amplitude. And this amplitude can be measured in a meter. Okay, now we discuss about the types of oscillation. Now here there are three types of oscillation: free oscillation, damped oscillation and forced oscillation. But in this video we discuss about first type of oscillation, that is free oscillation. Now definition of free oscillation is oscillation of a particle with fundamental frequency under the influence of restoring force, called as a free oscillation. Simply we can say, according to name, without any force the body will be oscillate under its a restoring force, or by using the restoring force, called as a free oscillation. Okay, now example of free oscillations are simple pendulum, car bouncing up and down, ringing bell, the current in an antenna. So these are some examples of free oscillation. Okay, now after that we discuss about the differential equation of free oscillation. For this, consider F be the restoring force acting on the oscillator. When it's a displacement from the equilibrium position, we considered as a x, then we can write the equation F is proportional to minus x. Now here we can write this equation like this: F is equal to minus kx. Give equation number 1. Now here k is nothing but the proportionality constant, and this negative sign indicates that this force and displacement both are in opposite direction. Okay, now after that, again we know that Newton's second law of motion, that is F is equal to ma. Okay, give equation number 2. Now from equation 1 and 2 we can write the equation ma is equal to minus kx. Okay, now here a indicates acceleration. Okay, and instead of this a we can write d square x upon dt square. That is, we know that acceleration is nothing but the velocity per unit time, and again velocity is nothing but the displacement per unit time, and therefore instead of this a we have taken d square x upon dt square. So we just put the value of a in this equation, we get the equation m into d square x upon dt square is equal to minus kx. Okay, now this right hand side term will take into the left side, therefore we can write this equation like this: m into d square x upon dt square plus kx is equal to 0. Okay, after that divide by m throughout this equation. So this equation we can write like this: d square x upon dt square plus k divided by m into x is equal to 0. Okay. Now after that, the term k by m is equal to omega square, and that omega represent angular frequency of oscillation. Okay. And therefore we can write this equation like this: d square x upon dt square plus omega square into x is equal to 0. Give equation number 3. And this equation 3 is nothing but the differential equation of free oscillation. Okay. Now after that we discuss about the solution of free oscillation. For this, consider an equation x is equal to e raised to alpha t. Give equation number 4. Okay. Now taking the derivative of this equation 4 with respect to t. So we get dx by dt is equal to d by dt of e raised to alpha t. Okay. Now derivative of this e raised to alpha t, we can write e raised to alpha t into alpha. Okay. Now one more time we have to take the derivative of this equation. So we get d square x upon dt square is equal to d by dt of e raised to alpha t into alpha. So now again derivative of this e raised to alpha t into alpha is equal to alpha square into e raised to alpha t. Give next equation, that is equation 5. Okay. Now put equation 5 in equation 3, that is here we have to put the value of d square x upon dt square in equation 3, that is here we have to put the value of d square x upon dt square. Okay. So we get the equation alpha square into e raised to alpha t plus omega square into e raised to alpha t is equal to 0. Here again we put x is equal to e raised to alpha t. Okay. So therefore from this equation the term e raised to alpha t will take common. Therefore we can write this equation like this: e raised to alpha t in bracket alpha square plus omega square is equal to 0. But the term e raised to alpha t is not equal to 0, and therefore that equation we can write like this: alpha square plus omega square is equal to 0, and therefore alpha square is equal to, we can write, minus omega square. But again we know that mathematical formula I square is equal to minus 1. So here we can write this equation like this: alpha square is equal to I square into omega square, and therefore we get alpha is equal to plus minus I into omega. And therefore we can write the general solution of free oscillation is x is equal to a into e raised to alpha t plus b into e raised to minus alpha t. Here we can put this alpha is equal to I omega. Therefore we can write this equation like this: x is equal to a into e raised to I omega t plus b into e raised to minus I omega t. Give next equation, that is equation 6. But the term e raised to I omega t is equal to cos omega t plus I sin omega t, and the value of e raised to minus I omega t is equal to cos omega t minus I sin omega t. Okay. Now put these values in this equation. Okay. So we can write this equation like this: x is equal to a into cos of omega t plus I sin omega t plus b into cos of omega t minus I into sin of omega t. Okay. Now here in this equation, just multiplied by a to this bracket and multiplied by b to this bracket. So equation becomes a into cos of omega t plus I into a into sin of omega t plus b into cos omega t minus I into b into sin of omega t. Okay. Now here take sin sin term will common and cos term will take common. So we can write this equation like this: a plus b into cos omega t plus I into sin of omega t, remaining term we can write in a bracket, that is a minus b. Now again here the value of a plus b is equal to, we put r into sin phi and the term I into a minus b we just put is equal to r into cos phi. So we can write this equation like this, x is equal to r into sin phi into cos of omega t plus r cos phi into sin of omega t. Okay, now after that r will take common from this equation, so equation becomes r into sin phi into cos omega t plus cos phi into sin of omega t. Therefore x is equal to r into sin of phi plus omega t. Now give equation number 7 where r represent amplitude of oscillated system. This bracket, that is phi plus omega t, represent phase of the motion and this phi indicates phase angle. So this equation 7 is nothing but the solution of free oscillation. Okay, now one more time we'll discuss about the derivation and solution of the free oscillation. So okay, now differential equation, for this consider F be the restoring force acting on the oscillator when its displacement is x from their mean position. Okay, so we can write the equation F is proportional to minus x. Therefore we can write this equation like this, F is equal to minus kx. Okay, give equation number 1. Now here this k indicates proportionality constant and that negative sign indicates that restoring force and displacement are in opposite direction. Okay, now again according to the Newton's second law of motion we can write the equation F is equal to ma. Okay, now from equation 1 and 2 we can write the equation ma is equal to minus kx. Now here again instead of this a we just put d square x upon dt square, so equation becomes m into d square x upon dt square is equal to minus kx. Okay, now after that this right hand side term, that is minus kx, will take into the left side, so equation we can write m into d square x upon dt square plus kx is equal to 0. Okay, now divide by m throughout this equation, so we can write this equation like this, d square x upon dt square plus k by m into x is equal to 0. Okay, now after that the term k by m is equal to, we can put omega square, and that omega is nothing but the angular frequency of oscillator. Okay, so by putting k by m is equal to omega square we can write this equation like this, d square x upon dt square plus omega square into x is equal to 0. Give equation 3. Therefore this equation 3 is nothing but the differential equation of free oscillation. Okay, now after that we discuss about the solution of free oscillation. For this consider an equation x is equal to e raised to alpha t. Give next equation, that is equation number 4. Now taking the derivative of this equation 4 with respect to t. Okay, so we get dx upon dt is equal to dy dt of e raised to alpha t. So derivative of this e raised to alpha t we can write e raised to alpha t into alpha. Okay, now one more time we have to take the derivative of this equation, so we get d square x upon dt square is equal to dy dt of e raised to alpha t into alpha, and again derivative of this e raised to alpha t into alpha we can write alpha square into e raised to alpha t. Give next equation, that is equation 5. Now put equation 5, that is we have to put the value of d square x upon dt square in equation 3, so we get alpha square into e raised to alpha t plus omega square into e raised to alpha t is equal to 0. Here also we put x is equal to e raised to alpha t. Okay. Now from this equation, the term e raised to alpha t will take common. Therefore, we can write this equation like this: e raised to alpha t in bracket alpha square plus omega square, and which is equal to 0. But the term e raised to alpha t is not equal to 0, and therefore we can write alpha square plus omega square is equal to 0. From this equation, again we can write alpha square is equal to minus omega square. Now we know that mathematical value, that is I square, is equal to minus 1. So we can write this equation alpha square is equal to I square into omega square. Okay. Now from this equation, alpha is equal to plus minus I omega. Okay. And therefore, the general solution of free oscillation, we can write x is equal to a into e raised to alpha t plus b into e raised to minus alpha t. Now here we put alpha is equal to I omega. So we get the equation x is equal to a into e raised to I omega t plus b into e raised to minus I omega t. Give next equation, that is equation number 6. But again, the value of e raised to I omega t is equal to cos omega t plus I sin omega t. And the value of e raised to minus I omega t is equal to cos of omega t minus I sin omega t. So we just put the value of e raised to I omega t and e raised to minus I omega t in equation 6. So we get x is equal to a into cos of omega t plus I sin omega t plus b into cos of omega t minus I sin omega t. Okay. Now here only just multiplied by this a to this bracket and multiplied by b to this bracket. Okay. So we get a into cos omega t plus a into I into sin of omega t plus b into cos omega t minus b I sin omega t. Okay. Now here cos cos term will take common and sin sin term will take common. So we get the equation a plus b into cos omega t plus I sin omega t in bracket a minus b. Now again here the value of a plus b is equal to r sin phi and value of I into a minus b is equal to r cos phi put in this equation. So we get x is equal to r sin phi into cos omega t plus r cos phi into sin omega t. Okay. Now again from this equation r will take common. Therefore r into sin phi into cos omega t plus cos phi into sin omega t. Now this bracket term we can write like this: r into sin of phi plus omega t. So give equation number 7. Here this r represent amplitude of oscillated system. Now the bracket phi plus omega t represent phase of the motion, and this phi indicates phase angle, and therefore this equation 7 is known as solution of free oscillation. Okay. Thank you.